It's Mailbag Monday again, and today's openings begin with the Dark Horse Black Lager from Namesake Brewing. They describe it as being dark, roasty, and fruity. An interesting combination. Huh. Namesake Brewing is located right here in Winnipeg. I hadn't heard of these guys before. Interested to try it. That's not quite as malty as I was expecting. Nice roasty taste, though. So the first thing out of the mailbox is something that came to my P.O. box. There is no information down there, so it is a couple of pieces of prototyping perf board. My various anonymous donors have sent me a few of these in the past, and I have, of course, bought plenty of them in the past. They do get used quite frequently. Anytime I've taken something off a breadboard and want to make it more permanent, this type of board tends to be my go-to. This stuff is super common, easy to find, and really, really cheap. For instance, there is 5 pieces of it for $1.35 Canadian with free shipping. Always useful stuff to have around, always handy, and I will include a link down below to the search term that finds this exact page on eBay. Next thing in is something that I ordered. Showed up, oh wow, I ordered that back in September. That's been chilling in the mail queue for a while. Let's see what we got. It is transistors, power transistors by the looks of it. Oh, 2 different kinds. What are you guys? The small bag is L7912 CV, which are negative 12 volt linear regulators. Looks like there's 5 of them in that bag. And the larger bag, is that more of them or is that something different? These are 7812, which are the positive 12 volt regulators. So those two would typically be used in combination to create a dual voltage 12 volt power supply. I'm assuming that I got more of the positive ones than the negative ones because that is more often what you're going to build. But regardless, those are both useful things to have in stock. 3 terminal voltage regulator, L7805, 7912, 7815, 7806, 09, 08, 24, 05, etc., etc., etc. I got, this one's priced in Australian dollars, odd. I got the 7912s and the 7812s from this listing, but I only ordered 5 pieces of each. I'm not quite sure why I got such a big bag of them, but hey, I'll take it. Thank you, seller's mistake, I guess. And yeah, I did order them way back in September. So they would have taken a month or so to get here, and then they've just been chilling in my mail queue. I'm glad I had that mail queue because I managed to get through the Canada Post strike without it impacting on my mailbags at all. And now things are starting to show up again. Woohoo! That's a lot lighter tasting beer than I expected it to be. It's still pretty nice though. So the next thing in is another thing from my P.O. box. This says LED light on it. That seems like a reasonable thing. Let's see what kind of LED it is. Again, wrapped in more foam. And again, it is more of these T10 style automotive bulbs. Every time I get a different one of these out of the mailbag, it's been a different color. Let's see what this one is. Ooh, that's, again, to me, that looks like a bright white, but my eyes always deceive me on colors. And this thing is drawing about 18 milliamps at 12 volts DC. So that should be another interesting one to add to the collection. And I have tracked down some sockets for these that I've ordered. They should be here eventually. We'll see what use I can put these to.
And as usual, for the things that have been sent anonymously to my P.O. box, I will link you to an eBay search, sorted as always, cheapest first. And among all the other T10 shapes and styles, we find probably these same ones. This looks anyway like the same shape and form factor. There are lots and lots of different varieties in this T10 plug. I guess the T10 specifies the plug and the general size and the fact that it is a 12 volt automotive bulb, but other than that, there is so much variety in them. Anyway, this, I'm pretty sure, this auction, 10 pieces for 14 cents plus $2.87 shipping, so essentially $3, is about the best price I can find, and it's the first one that I found with that shape on it. So there you go. Follow the link, search around. There's tons of variety to look through. All right, next thing in. This is another one that I've ordered, although it doesn't say on the package what it is, so... In we go. It is, oh, it is UV resin. Hard, it says. UV curable resin solution. And this is another thing that I ordered many, many months ago. Long before I got that, that resin 3D printer. And since I got it, I've actually been using the 3D printing resin as a UV glue. Although it's opaque, so you can't go very thick with it. But, this one even has a little UV, presumably UV flashlight. That's kind of neat. Runs on 3 AAAs. Okay, we'll have to pull that out and play with that. But the glue, thankfully, came in a sealed bag. Because I have ordered liquids before, and they have gotten all runny and all over the inside of the package. So we've got a cap here with a little dispenser. Okay, 2 to 4 minute curing time. With a 36 watt lamp, 5 to 10 minutes on a sunny day. All right, probably less in my UV printer curing station, and probably more with this little guy here. What else do we need to know about it? When it hardens, it'll heat up. Yes, all these UV curing glues or resins are exothermic when they're curing. Please be careful not to. Yeah, not good for the skin. This is likely very, very similar to the UV printer resin. 10 to 60 grams UV resin glue, highly transparent, quick drying, low odor, hard epoxy resin glue, UV lamp for jewelry making. I got the 50 gram set, which has one bottle of resin and one flashlight. And these days it's costing $8.79. And if you buy more than $10 worth from the same seller, you can get free shipping on it. As always, that changes on a day-by-day basis with AliExpress. You never know what's going to happen. Is there much else to say down here? Is the colorless transparent liquid? Okay, so you can go thicker with that because the UV can get through it. The one downside of using UV printer resin, or at least the grade that I've got as an adhesive, is you have to go in thin layers, harden each layer, and then build it up and whatnot, just like resin 3D printing. But in this case, I can use a much deeper, thicker amount of it, although I will have to shine UV on it for longer. But again, if I want, I can use that resin curing station that came with the resin printer. That'd be cool. Or I can use the flashlight that came with this thing, assuming it works. So let's just put some AAA batteries cells into this thing and give the whole system a shot. That loads just like any dollar store flashlight does. Yep, that works pretty well. So now let's see if this stuff works or if it's hardened or if I can even use it at all. Came with a foil seal on it, so that's nice. Although that seal is hard to get off, so I will just bypass it completely like this. And notice I am using my safety gloves to handle this resin because I am very concerned about it. Just wipe the blade of my X-Acto off. And let's shine that on there for a while and see what happens. Okay, that's interesting. Remember I said it was exothermic when it's curing? Well, this label is a thermal printer label, and you notice it's starting to darken the label. So, wow, that is actually working. And that is hard. That's not liquid anymore. Okay. Shine that underneath here and glue that foil. Oh, it's already stuck on there. It's not going anywhere. Okay. So clearly, both the UV flashlight and the resin itself works. Just peeled right off there. So I guess the
the, what is that stuff? The thermal printer paper is a little bit too slippery, or, well, delaminated the paper, I guess, but that, uh-oh. It works. Yay, it works. And, I would just add that to my adhesives arsenal around here, because I'm not sure if you remember, but way, way back at the beginning of the channels, I focused myself on testing a bunch of different adhesives that I had found to discover what worked best for various different projects. So that will be a good addition to my arsenal. And actually, this little flashlight will go well with that as well, if I don't have to use the big curing station if I don't want to. Right, on to the next thing. And actually, the next thing is the last thing. Again, it doesn't say what it is, so we'll just have to find out. A sample book. Oh, okay. This is a surface mount device sample book, storage book or whatnot. Hang on for just a second. Normally when you buy variety packs of surface mount devices, they come like this, or like this, or like this. This sample book is the solution, the typical solution for straightening these out and keeping them a little bit more accessible, really. Now you can get these books pre-filled with resistors or capacitors or LEDs or whatever, or you can just buy them empty like I have done here. So that's what's in my future, is sorting these guys out into here in order. Makes them a lot easier to find than digging through a whole bundle of those. And yeah, that's all it is just organization for surface mount devices. I don't use surface mount all that much, as I'm sure you've seen, but when you need to use them or when you're looking for one, it's just so much more convenient to have them laid out like that rather than in a jumble like this. 450 pieces, 8,000 pieces, etc. Resistor sample book, 170 values, etc., etc., etc. So the book itself, just the book, cost me $12.68 with free shipping. You can get it pre-filled with components as well. However, it like doubles the value of them. And to get an assortment pack of surface mount devices, like those various ones that I've got, is a hell of a lot less than, what's the difference there, $20? Yeah, you don't need to do that. So that's why I got the blank book, and I'm going to put the devices that I've got into it. I mean, it's sure a lot less effort to buy the book pre-filled. Looks like it comes with these nice little legends and everything, but for that price difference, especially since I've already got the components, I'm just going to get the book. If you know someplace cheaper to get them than that, let me know. Otherwise, there is a link to this down below in the description. And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Wide variety as always. From my anonymous donors to my P.O. box, I got more of these T10 LEDs in another different color. At least I believe it is. Got a couple of these perf boards, perforated prototyping PCB board, whatever you want to call them. And those are always useful things to have around. Thank you so much for those donations. And then I've got these 12-volt positive and negative linear regulators. Those are, you know, they're very common in old school power supplies. And I think I'm going to use a couple of these to upgrade a power supply that I've got around here from 5 volts to 12 volts, if it will take it. We'll see. And the rest of them are just for repair and other projects and whatnot. This UV glue, transparent UV glue, came with a UV flashlight. That's just a good addition to my adhesives arsenal. It can be used in a lot of the same places where super glue, crazy glue, whatever you want to call it, can be used. It can be used in a lot of places where a two-part epoxy like this stuff can be used. Or just, you know, any place that you need a hard glue that actually sets up quite quickly. Nice stuff to have around. And finally, this sample book for trying to organize my component collection. It's not really a collection, it's more of an accumulation. Calling it a collection implies that there's some order to it, and there certainly isn't. Well, Thank you, everybody, for watching. Thanks to the anonymous donors who send this stuff in. Thanks to my YouTube channel members and my Patreon supporters for helping keep the beer fridge full and helping me buy the rest of this stuff without going broke doing it. I appreciate all of you. And if anybody has anything to say about this, the questions and comments are available down below in the comment section. And, of course, there's links to everything down in the description as well. Anyway, thanks for watching. Talk to you later.